I've noticed that on YouTube there are a lot of videos out there which show extreme room makeovers. People do these in their bedrooms, kitchens, underground fight clubs, and the videos always seem to do really well and get billions of views. Obviously, I want a slice of that billion view pie, so today I'll be sharing my very own extreme living room makeover with you all. Now, typically, the makeovers that I've seen from other people involve quite simple changes, like adding a new rug or painting their walls a different color. But the makeover that you're going to see in this video is quite different because the actual structure of this room will be going through an extreme change with the addition of three roof lights from Velux. Velux are not sponsoring this video, but I do want them to sponsor me so they can have that shout out for free as a little sweetener. So if you missed my previous video, this is Sean Paul, and he's the joiner who will be orchestrating the entire renovation of the new place that I bought with my brother. To get started with the Velux installation, in that first segment, he was screwing the fixing brackets into the windows, which are then used to secure them to the roof. Before the Velux's could be installed, Sean Paul needed to prepare the roof for them. The first step here was doubling up the rafters, which are the pieces of wood which run down the roof here. After this, he went on to cut sections out of the rafters where the Velux's would actually be going, and then he moved on to creating the supporting frame which the Velux's would be held within. To create this supporting frame, he added two lengths of wood along the bottom called trimmers, and then added two more lengths of wood along the top, which are called headers. These were then secured using a nail gun with twist nails and some joist hangers, which are the little metal clips you'll see at either end of the trimmers and headers in a minute. To quote pretty much every single middle-aged dad on planet Earth, this entire process basically means that the Velux's wouldn't be going anywhere. As I've mentioned in my previous videos when speaking about the plans for this house, the addition of these Velux roof lights is probably the thing I was most excited about with this renovation. If there's one thing I've learned from my previous renovation of the tiny house, it's that you can't really make a room too bright. Well, I don't think you can. Light coloured walls and as much natural light as possible just makes your home a nicer place to be, in my opinion. I'm sure there are a few goths out there who probably disagree, but it's just from my own personal experience, I noticed that being in a bright space really makes me much happier. Back when I lived with my parents, I painted my bedroom a really dark green, and I must admit, I started to feel a little gothy. Started drinking Monster Energy and things like that. With the inside prepared for the installation of the Velux windows, the next step was preparing the outside. For this part, Sean Paul brought in the team from McGill Roofing and Rough Casting. For this job, the team comprised of Jacob, the owner of the business, Lewis, his apprentice, and Isaac, his brother, who was doing some labouring during his summer holidays. This section of the building was going to be getting re-roofed with new tiles, so the first job here was to remove all of the old tiles. Because these tiles are quite hard to come by nowadays, instead of just throwing away all of the old tiles, we decided to keep any that were in good condition and then threw away all of the bad ones. This just made sense in case the front of the building ever needed any replacement tiles. Plus, my tiny house also uses these exact same tiles, so it was just a good idea to hold on to some since, like I said, they're a bit of a rarity these days. One thing I do need to say is that I really appreciate how sound Jacob, Lewis, Isaac, and of course Sean Paul have been about me filming them the whole time. I always check and ask if it's okay to film them before I do, because I can imagine it must feel pretty odd being filmed. But they were always totally cool about it, which is really nice because that means I get to capture the whole process and share the ongoing transformation of this place with all of you. With the roof completely stripped and dusted, Jacob began laying the underlay. Not only does this underlay provide a second line of defense against rain and snow which might get driven under the tiles with the wind, it also acts as a temporary waterproof covering when the old tiles have been taken off and the new ones haven't been put on yet. It did actually rain overnight after the old tiles got taken off, but because this new underlay was already down, that wasn't really a concern. On Santoff's website, who are the brand that make this underlay, they say it can protect an untiled roof for up to a month. So if you've got a really lazy or really old roofer, it's a good option. Thankfully, Jacob, Lewis, and Isaac were absolutely rapid and had this roof stripped and retiled in just a couple of days. On that note, I will be showing the entire re-roofing process in my next video, so I'm looking forward to sharing that satisfying process with all of you as well. With the inside and outside of the roof prepared, the next step was cutting through the sarking boards where the Velluxes would be going. The cutting out of these sections was probably the most exciting part of the renovation so far, because it gave us a peek at how much natural light would actually be coming in through the Velluxes once they were installed. With each section that Sean Paul cut out, the room just filled with more and more natural lighting, contributing to what you might call an extreme room makeover. With the big sections cut out, Sean Paul then went up on the roof to cut back these openings a bit more and give them a cleaner edge for a tidier finish. Once the openings were tidied up, Jacob knocked in some extra battens around the openings, which the Velluxes would be fixed to using the brackets that you saw Sean Paul screwing into the windows at the very start of the video. Sean Paul then brought up and placed the Velluxes to prepare them for the final step. I should say I would include more chatter between them as they work, but I don't want to get hit with a copyright strike from the music being played on their radio. I just can't be having Elton John come out of the woodwork to strangle me with a lawsuit.
Awesome, isn't it? That's cracking, Georgie. It just looks perfect size and everything, eh?
After placing the Velluxes into their frames, Sean Paul went back inside and set up his laser level, which basically does what you would expect from that name. It shoots out a laser along the wall, which allows you to see that all of the windows are perfectly lined up.
You're sitting f***ing bang on here, mate. Perfect, lad. Perfect, lad. Bang on here, mate.
With all of the windows level, Jacob screwed the Velluxes in whilst Sean Paul did some final checks on how they were sitting. As we move into the before and after of the inside, as I said in my last video, if you want to see behind the scenes sneak peeks at this renovation, follow Sean Paul at Deborah Joinery on Instagram. He's at 600 followers now, and it would be really cool if you could all help out and get him to 1,000. I'll drop a link to his page in the description and also include a link to Jacob's Facebook page there as well. If you're in Fife or central Scotland and need a roofer, I can't recommend Jacob, Lewis, and Isaac enough. As I said, in my next video, I'll be showing the process of them completely re-roofing this section of the house, so be sure to subscribe if you'd like to see that. So that clip there showed this room, which is going to be the living room and the kitchen, before the windows were in and before the ceiling was raised. And this is the after. With the ceiling raised and with the Velluxes in, the guys have completely transformed the building, and I'm so pleased with the results. If you enjoyed this video, I'd appreciate you taking a second to leave a like and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you all in the next one.